Black poly gel with dual forms in this video coming up. I will need pH bond by Harmony, which is dehydrator and non-acid primer, but the same brand. I will also use gel base coat by Cupa and this black poly gel by Ronicky, which is number 7. I will also use gel play bling on by Accents to secure these beautiful rhinestones, and I will pick them up with Crystal Katana pickup tool. Few months ago I posted a video with a review of Ronicky poly gel, and you guys were really interested in the black one, and honestly this was the first black poly gel I have ever seen, so finally I decided to try it and see how it actually works. So here's the nail, I'm prepping it, I'm filing the length, which by the way is not necessary with dual forms, but I still decided to do it because it will be more comfortable when working with the nail when it's short. And then I will push back the cuticle with an orangewood stick and remove the surface shine with 180 grit file. After that I will prep the nail for the application, which is one coat of dehydrator, one coat of non-acid primer and a thin layer of the base coat, which I recommend you to use regardless of the technology you will be using, whether you want to use regular forms or dual forms, because it creates a better adhesion. And we will be working with poly gel afterwards, which is color poly gel, so I think we really need this. Cure for 30 seconds and now let's do this. So I have this dual form and this gel is pretty rough. I think you can see how hard it is to actually squeeze it from the jar. And now with the brush and the special liquid, I'm using the one by IBD. This is control solution. I'm basically creating the application backwards. So I'm applying the product inside of the dual form, which I will later apply on the nail. It may seem that you are just popping on the product inside and do not care how it goes, but this is not actually true. You need to sculpt it the same way you would create an actual nail. It should be thin near the cuticle, it should be thinner across the sidewalls, and you have to build the apex area in the middle, which is the thickest part of the nail. So we decided to do a short nail just to see how it goes, and after the application it is time to fit the dual form on the nail. So first you press and then you carefully slide a little closer to the cuticle, but I decided to leave the gap between the cuticle just to be sure, and also this is black poly gel, so I wasn't sure if the color will look good near the cuticle anyway, so you know, just decided to leave this gap. So the main advantage when working with this color is definitely that you can see every single bubble and just squeeze it out, because it's much more clearer than when you're working like with a clear product. Then turn the hand around and do not press too much. With a very slight touch I will clear up the underneath of the nail with the brush, and once it's all thin and even, cure in the lamp for 2 minutes. I'm not sure if this is the right cure time, but I couldn't find any instructions on this brand, so we just decided to cure it just to be sure. And by the way, it was burning really bad. So now it's time to remove the dual form, and wow, this surface looks just perfect, but it was a thumb and I picked the biggest size of the dual form that I have, but still we have sidewalls missing, which happens sometimes when a client has a really wide thumbs. So what you can do is just take a little bit from the jar and add the missing sidewall with your brush. I usually use this method for wide nails or for the thumbs when working with dual forms. That's why I think it is very important to know the basics, to have the skill of applying the product, of sculpting the nails. Because even if you choose to work only with dual forms, you still need to know how to do this, because you know, sometimes things like this happen and you still need to work with your brush. After that I will cure it again for a couple minutes, and now let's file the nail. So I'm removing the sticky layer from the sides, because this is where we added the products, as well as underneath the nail. So I'm using the carbide cone shaped bit to file the sidewalls and a little bit across the cuticle, Like I said, with this color, absolutely the advantage is that you can clearly see if you still need to file more, because unlike clear or even nude products, you just see every single detail. But the disadvantage, as I suspected, is that near the cuticle as well as along the sidewalls, we need to have a very thin layer. And when the layer is thin with the black, you can see this line right away, so it looks like you have a huge gap running from the cuticle and along the sidewalls, like the margin. And it looks fine when you're working with a nude or with clear, because it just looks natural, but not with black. So that was my main concern on how to work with this product. So I actually have an idea. It might be very good for French style nail art, when you will be using black instead of white only for the free edge. Probably for this one it will look good, as well as maybe for some ombres, for some fade designs. But for one color, well, I don't know. It is just really so much easier to use the regular color, such as nude or clear, and then take black polish or gel, whatever you like, and apply it on the top. And also, I believe that most clients, they still would like to change the color almost after every service, right? They do not wear just black all the time. So I guess this is not just a very good solution for one tone application. After filing only the cuticle area and the sidewalls, I'm slightly buffing the whole surface so the top coat will adhere, and we also need to seal it underneath as we had the product there, and cure this top coat for 30 seconds. So another disadvantage is, you may probably see it already, like near the cuticle, the area that we filed with the drill bit, it has so many bubbles, and this is just how this product is. It was pretty grainy, and that was my another concern, that if you file it a little bit, you will see these air bubbles. It will not happen if you just leave the nail like it is after applying the dual form, but obviously we cannot leave it like that because the product will lift after a while. We couldn't leave the nail just the way it is, because clearly it looks like it's just 2 weeks, 3 weeks outgrown nail, so we decided to add rhinestones all across the nail to make it look better. So to secure rhinestones, I'm using Bling On Gel by Accents. It's pretty thick gel, you just apply it in the areas where you would like to place your crystals, then you can move them a little bit if you want, and then you need to cure it for 30 seconds in LED. And to secure them even better, you can also outline them. You can use this gel right on top of the sealed shiny nail, but since I created just a frame, it will be okay if I will apply top coat like this, right in between the rhinestones, and I will cover them on one side all together and then cure it for 30 seconds. And just to be sure that they will be secured until the next service, I will also outline them from the other side, and I'm using the regular no wipe top coat for this one. Here's what we have. Besides all the bubbles and scratches that can be easily seen, it's pretty transparent. I'm not sure if camera shows it, so I will put the light underneath so maybe you can see it. I noticed that some brands also launched some colorful poly gel, so let me guys know what do you think about them. Have you tried them? Is it really worth trying? And thank you so much for watching. If you're first time here on my channel, consider subscribing as I post new nail art tutorials every week. I will see you in my next one. Bye! Just tripping.